Okay, so good morning. I'd rather not to open my camera, for I want you all to focus on the content that I'm going to have. Okay, so for now, let me have my shared screen first. Okay, so can you see this? So we are about to talk now this European literature. Okay, so last meeting, I do believe na naipasa ko naman ito, yung European literature. So now we're on our semifinals period and we will begin with the study of the European literature. Okay, so ano nga ba ang European literature? Of course, so for now students, welcome to the introduction of European literature. All right. It is fitting and proper that we put things in the context of European literature, whether as an observer or an insider or someone part of the entire continental Europe. So tayo dito ay observer and insider. Ayan. Okay, so this is the political map of Europe. So everything in here is Europe. Okay, ito ang sakit na Europe. Next. So, for your assignment, may aising nga kung sino ang nakinig at hindi. So, for your assignment, in our GC, just type it. Okay? In the GC, type it. What do you mean? What does Johann Wolfgang von Goethe means by the decline of literature indicates the decline of nation? Explain in the GC. The decline of literature indicates the decline of a nation. Paki-explain. Okay? I'll wait for that in your time. In the time of your class. Okay. So, for our intended learning outcomes, ano ba yung mga dapat nyong malaman after I discussed what European literature is? Okay. Number one, understand the concept. So, ano nga ba ang European literature? Discuss the time divisions. Kailan yung may mga time divisions, ano-ano yung mga time divisions ng European literature, or ano-ano yung mga era. Okay, and the influence of European literature today. Meron ba siyang influence as of now, and what are those? Okay. Let's have first yung una nating learning outcome, understand the concept of the European literature. So we have here Europe. Introduction of what Europe muna. Okay, ano nga ba ang Europe? Ito ay isa sa pitong continents. Okay, pardon, medyo maingay. Nandito kasi ako sa labas. So I have here nawawales. Nandito ang manok. Oh my God. Okay, moving on. So Europe is one of the 7 traditional continents. So physically and geologically, so physically, ang Europe daw ay nasa westernmost peninsula of Eurasia or the west of Asia. Again, Europe ay nasa west of Asia. Ang Europe naman is bounded to the north, north naman of Arctic Ocean and west of Atlantic Ocean, south of Mediterranean Sea and southeast of Caucasus Mountains in the Black Sea. Ang dami, no? So, in short, dyan naka-state si Europe. Okay? Si Europe daw ay nasa west ng Asia, nasa taas ni Europe, si Arctic Asia, nasa west ni Europe, si Atlantic Ocean, and nasa south si Mediterranean Sea. Okay? So, to the east, Europe is generally divided from Asia by water, okay? Divided si Asia and si Europe by water. Divide of the Ural Mountains, the Ural River, and the Caspian Sea. All right. So that is on the physical and geological part of Asia. Next. Let's have this European literature. When we say European literature, it refers, of course, to the literature of Asia. European literature refers to the literature of Europe. Okay. European literature includes literature in many languages. Okay. So European literature pala is not just about English, but it has different languages. Ano? So the modern written works are English. You better jot this down, okay? So we have this English, the Spanish, the French, the Dutch, the Polish, German, Italian, modern Greek, Czech, and Russian. Baka tatandaan. Again, what are the different languages of the European literature? Those are the following. Tatandaan. Okay? The important classic and medieval traditions are those in. Another thing na dapat tandaan, what are the important and classic medieval tradition? We have the Asian Greek, Latin, Old Norse, medieval French, and the Italian Tuscan. Okay, you better jot this down. Waiting na natin pagka nagkaroon ng graded recitation kung sino talagang nakinig at hindi. Alright, moving on. European literature. It is also known as the Western literature. Okay? European literature is also known as the Western literature. It is the literature written in the context of Western culture in languages of Europe. Okay? So, ang kinafollow niyang culture is the Western culture. Diverse as they are, European literatures like Indo-European languages are parts of common heritage belonging to a race of proud nations which boast the likes of Homer. Ito yung mga kumbaga inspiration sa European literature. Si Homer ang sumulat ng Iliad and Odyssey. Virgil, who wrote the Aeneid. Dante, who wrote the Divine Comedy, and Chaucer, who wrote the Canterbury Tales. From this literature, my favorite were this Iliad and Odyssey, the Divine Comedy, and Canterbury Tales. Ito ang top three ko when it comes to the literature, literary works. This and other literary masterpieces form part of what we call as the Western canon. Pakatatandaan. Okay. Ano nga ang bumubuo sa Western canon? We have the Iliad and Odyssey, the Aeneid, the Divine Comedy, and the Canterbury Tales. Alright. The list of works in Western canon varies according to the critics' opinion. The great books of the world, of the Western world, is an attempt to present the Western canon in a single package of 60 volumes. Okay, so this literary piece, the great books of Western world, it attempted, ano, na isulat sa isang book lang yung 60 volumes ng Western canon. They attempted, pero hindi natuloy. Okay? The great books of Western world attempt to present the 60 volumes of the Western canon, pero hindi natuloy. Okay, so dito muna tayo, hanggang dito muna tayo, okay? Bago tayo, dito muna tayo sa introduction kasi medyo mahaba na agad. Okay, Indo-European languages and literatures. The common literary heritage is essentially originating in ancient Greece and Rome. It was preserved. Okay, again, it is the Indo-European languages and literature is originally from the Greece and Rome. Pakatatandaan, Greece and Rome. Original, the original state na Indo-European languages. It was preserved, transformed, and spread by Christianity. Malaki ang naging part ng Christianity in the spread of the literature. Okay? And thus transmitted to the vernacular languages of the European continent, the Western Hemisphere, and other regions were settled by Europeans. Okay. Ito, to the present, this body of writing displays a unity in its main features that sets it apart from the literature of the rest of the world. The languages may be varied. Okay, so ito ang sinasabi kong European languages. Tatandaan lahat. Sasauluhin. What are the European languages? We have the Greek, Latin, Germanic, Baltic, Slavic, Celtic, Romance, Finnish, Hungarian, and the Semitic languages such as Hebrew and not Indo-European. Okay. Again, tatandaan itong European languages. Ang epic ng aking manok. Nakakainis. Okay. The common literary heritage. Ayan, so. The common literary heritage is essentially from the Greece and Rome and is part of and is in the spread of the Christianity. To the present day, this body of writing displays a unity in its present day. Okay. So that could be all for now. Dito muna tayo sa intro, okay? Pakatatandaan lahat ng aking sinabi. Because on Wednesday, we will have a graded recitation. Again, on Wednesday, we will have a graded recitation. Okay, so going back, that could be all. So if you have any questions, just PM me or in the GC. Okay, goodbye class. Good day. Keep safe, everyone. Bye.